good day. Welcome back to this new session of AxelTech On Air. Today we have people connecting from Europe, Africa, and Americas, normally. Thank you very much for being with us today for this new session. I'm here today with Marco Branzanti.
Hello, everyone.
Thank you, Marco, for being here.
Pleasure.
And thank you again to Stefano Grego, who organized this event, and to Gianluca Righi, who is our director. If you're following us on YouTube, please do not hesitate to send us any question through the bell here below. If you're following us through Facebook, you can use the live chat, and we will be more than glad to answer to any doubt. Today we are here to present something new.
Correct.
Again, yeah. So very glad to do that.
Yeah.
So last year, Marco, we introduced to the market a new range of
audio processors.
Correct. Okay. So we have the new Falcon X5, X7. Today we are introducing the last piece of this range of products.
Yes.
So, ladies and gentlemen, here we are with Falcon D7.
Correct. The Falcon D7 is actually the little brother of the X7, since it's lacking the FM feature. Just a little introduction. Axel Technology, probably one of our first products, which was in our catalog, it was last century. So more than 20 years ago, we started with our Falcon 15.
Yeah.
And essentially, the audio processor is there. Yeah, Gianluca is, oh, okay. Okay, so the audio processor was actually invented or made for the FM stations to keep the regulations in order to stay in their bandwidth. Usually, for example, here in Italy, we have a 75 kilohertz deviation.
Mm-hmm.
So what happens is, if you want a larger volume, more sound, what happens is, in FM, you actually occupy more bandwidth.
Okay.
So probably you go against the other radio stations, which is just next by. So that's a regulation you should keep. So the processor main intention was to get maximum volume and maximum impact while always being restricted to that 75 kilohertz. And the other issue is the bandwidth was also limited in as far as audio bandwidth, which goes from 30 hertz to 15 kilohertz. And that's kind of very typical for the FM world.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, FM audio processor is the major seller. Why? Every radio station needs one in order to maximize their performance, their audio performance according to deviation. Then, of course, in these sixth generation of audio processors, what it actually does, it actually gives you color, it gives you dynamics.
Yeah.
You have a lot of options. We'll talk about that later.
The identity.
It's the tone. And then this is kind of also very subjective. You know, each ear is kind of very different from one another. We can talk about that. But first of all, I want to just show you the specs. So what's the difference from the D7 to the X7? Well, first of all, it doesn't have the MPX connectors because you don't need them. Those are only in FM. But most of all, it has a wide range of bandwidth, which means that it works from 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz.
Okay.
So you can't use this in FM. And where will you use it? Well, typically you use it in TV stations.
Okay.
So, simply because now TV is all digital, so you want the full bandwidth possible. And the other use is with the like web radios or HD radios, for example.
Okay.
So we have like a dual usage for the unit. Of course, unit is a little cheaper than the X7. That's why we call it the little brother.
Okay.
But it has, apart from these differences, which I've said, it has all the features that are also included in the X7.
Okay.
So first of all, wide range processing. We're talking from 20 to 20 kilohertz. And for the TV, there is also a nice add-on, which is the loudness control.
Sure.
So we'll talk about the algorithm, maybe looking at the GUI, etc.
Okay,
first of all, what I want to show you is this is actually the physical unit, which is a one rack unit. It has a lot of connectors on the back. We'll talk about all that. That's one of the major features of all our audio, new audio processors, a lot of inputs and outputs. And of course, on the front, we have a color display. The unit is off right now, but we have a photo probably that Gianluca can show you. And then a knob to select what you want to see. Of course, all the settings are kind of advanced, and it's kind of hard to set the settings directly from the front panel.
Too many features.
Right. So the front panel is just for viewing the status of the machine and how it's working. Well, and then you have some LEDs for alarms, etc. Well, the setup of the machine is usually done hooking up with a LAN card from the LAN directly. It has a web server built in, so you just hook up an iPad, a PC, or
just
whatever.
Connect,
yeah, with a
web.
Browser. And you just connect to the machine and you're done. Actually, we give kind of a nice accessory as well. Shipped with each unit is a small Wi-Fi USB dongle.
USB.
And you can put it in the front.
You create your own network.
In case you don't have a network on the back, you can put the USB Wi-Fi and it generates a Wi-Fi so you can enter with your iPhone and then do all your business. So let's see. I'm going to connect to the machine. Here I have a browser.
Yes,
it's just a Chrome, let's say. And I'm passing to the graphic view. And now we can already see a general view. Sorry, what do you need? Display settings. Oh, let me do it. Yeah, you don't see the second monitor. Well, display. Yeah, we're hooking up. Sorry for that. So let's start talking about something else while Gianluca fixes up
So I have a question for you.
Yeah.
Actually, this product is a new product in for as far as concerned the radio. It's going to cover actually something that it's new. So
correct for
web radios and
HD radios, which don't have an FM output. Let's
say.
Okay.
But it also. It is also going to cover the market that was previously covered by our Falcon 3 TV.
Okay.
We had an SDI option for the Falcon 3 TV.
Okay.
So how are we going to cover
Of course. What we tried to do, we tried to not make a different unit for the SDI.
Yeah.
Also because we did have an SDI version in the previous generation. And it was fine until we only had a standard definition and high definition.
Yeah.
Now people are getting more, let's say, expectation out of the unit. So we would have to go to the 12G, the 4K.
Yeah.
And this would actually influence the cost of an internal, the embedder and embedder. So what we did, since also on the market appeared many converters, and they're all kind of low cost.
Yeah.
So what we prefer is that we do the embedding and the de-embedding outside of the unit.
Right.
And we have kits, which are pre-prepared.
Yeah.
And actually, there are three kits. One kit which covers up to HD, so it has an embedded SDI to audio and audio to SDI in HD. We give you the cabling, a nice rack support to make things nice and tidy.
Yeah.
And then there's a 6G, which is a 4K 6G connection. And then there's a 12G connection.
Okay.
So three kits. Okay, do you want the embedding, this embedding option? Yeah, and we make this. Of course, we don't produce the embedders and the embedders.
Course,
we buy them off the market, and then we kind of
we
do a nice integration.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, that's great.
Okay, probably Gianluca fixed our computer output. This is the GUI, and this is the home screen. And as you see, it's kind of very typical for an audio processor.
Yeah.
It has the left part, which gives you the audio sources. We'll talk about that. The central part, which is actually the audio processing, and then the output in which we have a dedicated section for the loudness ITU 1770.
Okay.
Let's go with the first part. So we'll talk about the IOs. The system has, this is probably the most complete processor on the market with so many inputs and outputs.
Okay.
Why? After six generations of audio processing, we've kind of done the maximum we can as far as audio. I mean, audio processing power of the unit is more than you need. It's best on the market, best of the breed, and you can do so much to it. So in order to give added value, we kind of made a lot of accessories all around the audio processing module. So first of all, of course, you have analog inputs, which are, and analog outputs, which are balanced, of course. ASUB, digital inputs and outputs. I think it's two and two. And then we have a multimedia module, which can actually receive two audio streams from the network, so right. IP streams. We also have a file player. What is that? You can put an SD card on the back. There's a small slot. Okay. You put your music inside, and you can use that as a source, right, like right. a random playlist, okay. etc. And that's for the input. As far as the output, the IP output, this is kind of very interesting. You can stream directly to a cloud server. Okay. So if your radio goes on the web, you don't need an audio encoder. The processor will actually stream to your Shoutcast or Icecast okay. server on the cloud, and then from there, the distribution to the final customer. So no, the audio encoder is built in, okay?
That's great.
And then we have another cool option, which is the Dante option.
Of course.
So it's an option because, of course, we have a small module.
Yes.
You just put it in.
Okay.
We'll give you the price afterwards, actually. And with the Dante option, you get two audio inputs Dante and two audio outputs Dante. What are all these audio inputs and outputs for? Well, it's more for the radio world rather than the TV world, and it acts as an automatic changeover. So the system you can choose, actually, you can assign any inputs for up to four of this group. You create a four input, and then you tell the system to automatically switch with priority according to which signal are present or not. And you avoid to have a changeover. Changeover in radio station is kind of typical in order to ensure if you have your main studio, which for any reason goes off air, the system can switch to a backup studio. But here you can also switch to an IP stream or actually you can just play music from the internal player. So very, very flexible. Okay, so this is the input part. Let's go with processing. Mm-hmm. Of course, as I told you, sixth generation processing does a lot of things. It's a five band compressor with AGC in the input, stereo enhancer, super bass, says a lot of nice things. This is kind of the most, I know about radio stations when they get their processor, they choose something from a preset inside, and we give you a lot of presets. So if I go in the factory presets, as you see, I have a TV general purpose. Why? Well, TV has cartoons, movies, music.
Yeah.
So let's say that, so the curve and the settings of the preset must be kind of generalistic, but we have something for movie channels, so a lot of, dynamics, something for news. And for each of these, we actually have multiple presets. So some are more light, let's say, other are more compressed in order to give more dynamics and more power. So I always suggest, since this is probably one of the operations which, let's say, it's more delicate because it's more subjective. So, you know, the audio, let's say, enjoyment, you know, it depends really on your personal taste. And I have radio stations which start from a preset and then they can go and adjust each single parameter very
one by one,
delicately. And so I know of some radio owners that actually take up to a year before they really find, you know,
Why?
Because it's normal. Each radio and TV want their audio to be distinctive as a signature. And the audio processor is, you know, the song may be the same song that each radio station is playing.
Yeah.
But how you listen to it, how you feel it, really depends on the audio processor. And that's why for radio station is such an important piece of equipment. Okay?
Right.
Okay, now we're talking, until now, a little bit both radio and TV. Now I'm going to focus just on the TV part.
Okay.
Why? The loudness processing is something that, just to explain it a little bit, I want to give you an example. Let's say you're listening into the TV station, there's an interview, so just voice, or you're listening to a concert from, I don't know, Deep Purple or something like that. If you look at the view meters and you put them at the same level, the level actually gives you the electronic strength of the signal, electric strength of the signal. But it doesn't really tell you the amount of volume. If you listen to the TV, the concert will seem so much louder. Why? Because it depends on the energy which is contained into the signal.
Okay.
So they may seem the same, but one contains a lot more energy. Loudness is exactly this concept, the concept of measuring how much energy is in the signal. So there, in many countries around the world, mm-hmm. they are making laws right now. Why? To protect the viewers against bad use, I don't know, of advertisement, audio volumes, and so forth. Obama in the United States made the Obama Calm Law several years ago, and it was to enforce TV station to use the loudness. Okay. What is effectively loudness, technically speaking? It's the use of a specific algorithm, which is called ITU-1770, okay. and it actually defines how to calculate the energy inside the audio. The energy is represented by a single view meter. If you see it here, it's called loudness true peak. Okay. And even though it's a stereo signal, the energy content can be measured with one single value. Okay. So even if you're like in a 5+1 or a 7+1 Dolby surround, the loudness will be just one value. And in our system, what we do is we measure it constantly. Okay. We actually, there's other ways of measuring the loudness, which is integrating in time, so short term, middle term, and long term, and we give you also these parameters.
Okay.
And what you can do is each country is adopting their own standard of level. So, for example, here in Europe, we're it's the law is called R128, and we're actually the value is minus 23, and that's where you put in the parameters. Mm-hmm. In the United States, for example, is 80, 85, something like that, and the value is minus 24. So you can adapt this according to the country law you're using into it. I want to tell you something. Loudness control is actually not better than non-loudness control, in the sense in the sense that if your country does not oblige you, you without using the loudness, you would get a more dynamic sound, which is actually what you want. Of course, when in the near future, which is happening all throughout the world, the countries will oblige their TV station, you'll have to adapt. And what does it do? It actually controls the volume.
Okay.
Let me also put how...
So it is not basically a quality issue, but just...
A control issue, not to say get very different volumes out of your out of your playout system. So the bottom part, actually, what we did is we also made some schematics. So on the bottom right, you get actually a representation of your distribution of your volumes. And here there's a clock, which is a 12-minute clock with rotates, and shows you actually how your volumes are going during this process.
Through the day.
So the other interesting thing which we added just for this feature is the data recorder. Then, of course, we adapted the data recorder to all the other settings. You can choose eight settings, eight value, eight measurements among all the parameters which are inside, which are hundreds actually. Among these, of course, you can choose the loudness, and you can tell the system to log the values inside its internal memory and keep the logs for years. And why is this? Well, of course, it's already happening. Sometimes the government will check you and ask you and tell you, hey, last Friday you had some issues with your audio. And what you can do is you can export your logs into an Excel format
And prove it.
So it's like a form of certification built into the machine. So the machine corrects the audio using loudness, records the values, and allows you then to export and print out all these values. Okay? So these are the differences and features which are built inside the D7. Of course, if you look at the specs of the X7, all the other features are present, since this is a derived version from that one. And it is a little cheaper, right, Simona?
Yeah, we will see the price later. Now we have a question from Thomas.
Okay.
Hello, Thomas. Thank you for your question. How many outputs the Falcon D7 can generate concurrently?
Well, that's very interesting.
So
we have, I think, two analog outputs, two digital outputs, two IP streams, and two Dantes.
Okay.
Then there's a complicated routing. Let's see it. So here I have my output section, and when I go into the advanced, I can see exactly what type of outputs I can have. So what do I do? So I have three concurrent main outputs, which are digital one, digital two, and the analog.
Okay.
And you can choose with a system of let's say, switchers, internal switchers, you can choose the source among all the sources that I've told you. The loudness control can be activated or deactivated on one of the outputs.
Okay.
So you can have one output with loudness, the other output without loudness, and then the other with,
so you can customize it as much as you want.
Correct.
Actually.
So I have, let's say, two digital outputs, which are here, which are selected from, let's say, from there. So I would say simultaneous three.
Yeah.
That's
so
my
for example,
count.
So, if you have a web radio.
Right.
That can also be a TV music channel.
Correct.
You can use it for both.
Correct.
Perfect.
Correct.
Okay, great. So we were mentioning the
price
before. So the price list of this unit would be 2,495 euros.
Right.
And then if you will need the Dante option, the price for the Dante option would be 595 euros.
Right. So it's approximately 500 euros cheaper
than
the FM version, which has the MPX connectors built inside, right?
Yeah, of course.
So well,
I think we don't have any further questions, but of course, if you have any doubt, you can always write to sales@axeltechnology.com.
Right.
I'm Simona Lippi, I'm part of the sales team of Axel Technology, so you can write to me or both to my colleague Ilaria Malucelli or to Cristiano Cinelli if you are from Italy. Thank you again, Marco, for being with us.
It's a pleasure.
Our pleasure. And thank you again for being with us today to attend this live session. See you next time.
Bye-bye.
Bye.